Hello and welcome back to another video. Today we're taking a look on how to create this animated facecam. So one of my most popular videos is this animated facecam tutorial that I did a while back, and I thought it was time to update it. And like always, if this video gets 800 likes, I will release the PSD for this. And so without further ado, let's get right into it. Alright, so in Photoshop, let's go to File, New, and let's make a new document that is 1920 by 1080, resolution on 72, and the background color on black. Just click Create. We can make a new layer to grab our rectangle tool right here. I'm going to drag out a basic shape, doesn't really matter. Make sure we have disabled the fill and we have enabled the stroke. So it should look something like this. Then we're going to make the width 1280 and the height 720. Then I'm going to increase the stroke to around between 25 and 30. So I think, yeah, about 28 looks good. Perfect, yeah. So then we can just right click and rasterize this layer because we have with the shape and all that. I'm going to press Ctrl and R to get these like rulers right here. I'm going to drag out X guideline and put it in the middle. It should just snap in place and do the same for the Y axle. So now here we have the center. I'm just going to position this in the center just like so. Yes, should snap right into place. Right, the first thing I want to do is we're going to go to our gradient tool. I'm going to select this gradient, should be quite an almost black color to a little bit of a dark gray color. I have the hex codes in the description if you want to copy and paste and make and have the same gradient. But when we're happy with the gradient, just press OK. We're going to select this this radial gradient. Then we want to press Ctrl and click on the rectangle to select the area. It's from the middle, just drag out to the left. We have made a really nice gradient to our border. Next up, I'm going to double click on the rectangle to bring up the layer styles. I'm going to add a bevel and a boss. The highlight mode should be an overlay with color white. Style on inner bevel, technique at chisel hard, depth at 1000% and the size at 1 pixel. Perfect. Now I'm going to add an inner glow as well. So, and the inner glow should be on the blending mode overlay, opacity to 100%, color white, choke at 1000% and the size at 1 pixel. Perfect. Next up, I want to cut it into a shape that we like, so we can enable the guidelines again to help us. Let's make a new layer above it. Grab our polygonal last tool. We're going to create the shape that looks something like this, so pay close attention. So from about the middle of the border to about right here is go down, pressing shift to make a 45 degree angle. We need to move forward just a little bit to about, I think right here is good, to the middle of the border again. Just go via the guidelines and connect it. Control and backspace to fill it in with any color, doesn't really matter. Now we can press Control and click on this new shape layer that we made. So now we have this shape selected. We go back to our rectangle, that is our facecam, and press delete or backspace. So then we're going to do the same thing with every corner. So just flip it horizontally, move it to this side. Press Control to select the area and delete it on our main rectangle. Flip it 90 degrees, Control, delete on our rectangle. So if we just delete this shape because we don't need it, we have this interesting shape going on. So now I want to add some like small shapes to give a little bit of color to the border. So I think we start right here on the vertical line, or the vertical, doesn't really matter, on this side at least. So make a new layer, grab our polygonal lasso tool, or the pen tool if you like that more. I'm pressing shift all the time to create 45 or 90 degree angles, or even 80 degrees, 190 degrees. So yeah, just connect it to create a shape just like this. Just go to the backspace and choose the color of your choice. I'm using green. So then we can add a gradient to it. I already made a gradient right here. Dark green to a lighter green. So if you want to do this on your own, just choose a dark to light gradient of the color you want. Then I'm going to add a bevel and emboss. Just like so. Should be the default from the rectangle that we just made before. Press Alt and have the move tool selected. We can just click and drag on this layer to make a duplicate. I'm going to make this shape white. So first we want to right click and rasterize the layer style. Then Ctrl and U. And the saturation to -100%. We can just drag up the lightness. I think I just want to resize this a little bit to be a little smaller. So I'm just going to do that. Perfect. So now I want to duplicate this and put it at every like corner right here and on the other side as well. So just shift and select our two layers right here. Control and J to duplicate, and just control and T and right click and just rotate 180 degrees. Make sure it is in place. Yeah, nice. We can select all the layers that we have duplicated so far. Control and T, right click and flip horizontally. And drag it to the other side. So perfect, yeah. Now we can make a group of this. Use Control and G to make a group. Let's add another layer. Good to add a similar shape down here. Just grab our polygonal lasso tool. I want to create a shape that is like something like this. Perfect, and just control backspace to fill it in. And I want to add the same layer style that we used before. So nice dark to light gradient and the bevel and emboss. Perfect. Make a new layer above that. And I want to create a white similar shape that follows the green one that we just made. And then make a new layer and just add one more shape at the end. You can actually use it on the same layer. Should be just a little bit smaller. Perfect. And we have a shape down here. We can select all the layers. Control and J and duplicate it. Right click, flip it horizontally and put it on the other side as well. Select all the layers that we have right now. Control and J and flip it 180 degrees. Move it up so we have it on the top as well. Just like so, perfect. So we can select all these layers that we've made and put them into a group. Perfect. Let's make a new layer above it as well. Grab our polygon lasso tool again. We want to create a shape that looks something like this. So when we come to a corner right here, just hold down shift of course and drag up 45 degrees. It should kind of meet with this angle right here and connect it. And just grab a color from the rectangle or border and just fill it in. Now we want to duplicate this layer to bring it to layer styles, and we want to add our inner shadow. Put the color on the black, and the blending mode doesn't really matter, just put it on normal or something. Put the opacity all the way up to 100%. And I'm just going to mess around with the distance, the choke and the size. Right, so I'm pretty happy with this kind of look. So just to emphasize it a little bit more, we're going to add an outer glow. And it should be in the color white. And we can put the blending mode to overlay. Just increase the spread just a little bit and decrease the size. There is a small thin outline to make it more visible. So I'm just going to add, I'm just going to make a new layer and add a nice little green shape right here to just round it off. Perfectly side rectangle. Just fill it in with the color of your choice. And now we're going to duplicate this and put this at every like corner right here. Alright, so I'm just going to add three more shapes to our main border. Let's make a new layer and to zoom in on the top right here. I'm going to create a like a small rectangle at an angle. So kind of like so. I'm just going to fill it in with the nice color from our rectangle. Just fill it in. Right click and we'd add an inner shadow that we used before. Could be like the same or similar. Kind of like so, perfect. So it's going to show our guidelines. We can put it in the middle. We need to duplicate it two more times. So one, two. Put one to right and the other to the left. Perfect. So just duplicate one more time. We have to fill it in with a green that we like. We can of course disable the inner shadow, put a nice auto glow to it to make it green, put it on lighter color just like so, and we duplicate it two more times, put it over the boxes, perfect, just like so. So now we can put all these layers into a group. We're then going to animate them. So let's continue with our box down right here. We can have some recent donation, subscribers, and maybe your logo or something like that. So just under the rectangle or the main border right here, create a new layer, go to the rectangle marker tool, just drag out the rectangle kind of like so, just eyeball it. Going to grab our rectangle tool, I mean the gradient tool with the radial gradient selected that we used before, it's from the middle, drag out. Right, perfect. So just make sure by using Ctrl and T that is connected to the end right here and on the other side as well. It seems to be, yeah, not all the way. Yes, perfect. So now just double click on the layer to add some layer styles. First off, add an inner shadow, put it at 90 degrees and increase the distance so the shadow comes from above, because I want to separate the main border from the box down below. Just mess with the settings, yeah, kind of like that. Then we want to add our bevel and emboss, put it at minus 90 degrees with the size at 1. We can also put the inner glow, but I want to make this one soft light actually. We can decrease the opacity as well. So now grab our rectangle, the polygon lasso tool, and from the edge right here, press down shift, we create a 45 degree angle, just make a selection and press backspace to delete it. So we get this nice angle of the box. And do the same thing on the other side as well. Right, so below that, so below this box, create a new layer and use the polygon lasso tool. I'm going to create a shape that looks kind of like, control and backspace it with a green color, make a new layer above that. I'm going to create a new layer, make a similar shape but make it a little bit longer, kind of like so. Just connect it, make a selection and grab a nice kind of gray white color and just fill it in. Perfect, just duplicate these two shapes right here, put them horizontally and put them on the other side as well. That's so perfect. So now I want to add the logo or the text. So I'm just going to import my logo. Perfect, just like so. Put it above our rectangle down right here. Use the guidelines to position it in the middle. I'm going to create a gradient on it. So use the gradient, use the green gradient that we used before. Add a bevel and a boss. Put the angle at 90 degrees. And that's about it. So you just can do the same thing with the text if you like, if you don't have a logo. So now the last thing I want to do is add the sub boxes, or where you can display information. So let's make a new layer. Grab our polygon and lasso tool. Try to make a nice box just like so. Just connect it. Just fill it in with a similar dark gray color. Right, so put it below our logo or the text. Double click on this rectangle that was created, and we'll put an inner shadow. And when we're happy with the inner shadow, I want to create a pattern overlay. So I'm using this pattern right here, and the blending mode divide. And then use the scale, and I like to have the scale at 100%. You can also create a nice little small outer glow. Put a color on white and the blending mode on overlay to separate it a little bit from the box. Duplicate it and flip it horizontally and put it on the other side as well. Alright, so now we've created those like sub boxes right down there. And I'm just going to add two more shapes before we animate this in After Effects. So just blow everything, I mean above everything, grab our rectangle tool at and above right here, create a small vertical shape, kind of like so, fill it in with white. Perfect. We can then duplicate this and make it green. Perfect, and just put it on the other side. Alright, so then let's head over to After Effects. But before that, I just want to show you how to get the files into After Effects. You could put the whole PSD that we just made into After Effects, and I'm going to do that. But I'm just going to make one thing, because we used 43 layers, and if we put and so much information in After Effects, it will take quite a while to render it out. And we're basically just going to animate a few layers. So I want to animate these two shapes right here, so I will leave them in the PSD. I'm going to animate these shapes at the top, so I'm going to leave them. I'm not going to animate these. Not going to animate these. Not going to animate those. I'm not going to animate the whole shape. I'm going to animate the logo or anything like that. So all those things that you're not going to animate, just put them into a group. You can hide the background so we can make it transparent, and just leave all the things that you're going to animate. So right here we have all the things that we're not going to animate. Then go to file, save as, put the output to PNG and name it whatever you want. Just export that as a PNG and just enable all the things so we can see them. Save this PSD and let's head over to After Effects. Alright, so in After Effects I'm just going to create a new composition. I will make it 1920 by 1080, having the frame rate at 60. But of course you want to have the frame rate that you stream in and the resolution you stream in. I'm going to keep the duration on 10 seconds and the background color could be black. Press OK. So first off, we are going to import the PSD that we just made in Photoshop. See, let's load in. Make sure it's composition, retain layer sizes, and make sure the layer options is editable layer styles. Press OK and the Facecam will load. Yeah, so perfect. So like I talked about, we have saved all the things that we're not going to animate as a separate PNG. So we're going to import that as well. Just let it load. And now we have that just separate. So let's open up this cam tut or wherever your PSD is named. Just double click that. And we can actually delete the group where we're not going to, that we're not going to animate. So I guess in this case, it's going to be group 5 for me. Just delete that. And we can actually bring in that PSD, I mean that PNG, and have that just for reference. Perfect. We can also drag these guidelines to the sides because we don't really need them anymore. Perfect. So I'm going to start off by animating these three. Oops. These three like thing imaging is those rectangles up here. So in this case, this is I made it a group in Photoshop. So I'm just going to double click it. And let's start off by animating. So in Photoshop we made three that were like hollow or less like black, as you can see. We made four that were green. So now we're going to animate the green ones popping up and popping back down again. So you say 0 seconds. Press T on our keyboard to bring up the opacity. So I'm going to do that for the first rectangle. So just press T. I'm going to start off by making a keyframe for the opacity by clicking the stopwatch right here. Make the opacity 0. Move forward to about half a second later and put the opacity at 100. Select both keyframes. F9 to ease the ease. Then we can go to the graph editor right just up here. Make sure you have edit speed graph selected. I'm going to grab those two points right here, drag them towards the middle, the other one as well, and let's see how it looks. Perfect, just lights up real smooth, just like so. I'm going to copy these two keyframes by just selecting them and Ctrl and C. You can show our next little rectangle and just Ctrl and V to paste them. And if we press U, we can see the keyframes that we have pasted in. So let's see how that looks. Perfect. We already have these keyframes copied, so we're going to paste them to our third rectangle over here. Press U to see them, and we have something that looks like this. Perfect. So now I want the third rectangle to go away or get darker again. So just wait like a half a second or a second. Make a keyframe for the opacity of the third rectangle at 100%. Move forward half a second and put it to 0. So now we have animated the opacity going back to 0. Let's see how it looks. Perfect. Just copy these two keyframes and paste it to the second one. Let's see how it looks. Perfect. I'm going to move a little bit forward. And after this, if in the middle one gets dark again, I want it to light up. So the first keyframes that we made was to light up. So I'm just going to copy one of those, paste them just a couple of frames ahead. And now we have something that looks like this. Right, so after that, I want the third to light up again. Just paste those light up keyframes to our third rectangle. Perfect. So now I want all these rectangles to go dark again, so we can loop this. So copy the keyframes that go from 100% to 0. Just paste them to every layer. Kind of like so. Let's take a look. Perfect. So if we go back to our cam, we can see how it looks. Right, so that's perfect. So now I want to loop this one more time. So let's start off by loop in the first one. So let's select all the keyframes for the first rectangle and just paste them just like so, and do the same thing for the other one. And of course do the same for the third one. So let's take a look. Right, it's perfect. That's a really clean loop. So when we're done with those lights, I want to animate these two like lines right here going up and down. So let's see. So this should be the layer 11 that we saved on top. Let's start off with the white one. So first off, start at 0 seconds, press P on our keyboard to select the position properties and make a keyframe for the position. Move forward to about 1 second and drag the Y value, which is the second value, down to about right here. Just goes up and down. You can select those keyframes and just F9 to ease to make the animation a little bit more smooth. Then I want to go to effects and presets that we have right over here. But if you can't find them, just go to window and locate it from there. So I'm just going to search up linear wipe, drag it and add it to our layer. Put the wipe angle to 180 degrees and at 0 seconds set the transition completion to 100%, and in the middle between these two position keyframes put the transition completion to 0%. Move forward to the last keyframe and put it back to 100%. We can of course select all those keyframes as well and F9 to ease. Let's see what we have. Okay, looks clean, but we can mess with the position keyframes to make sure this starts like above right here. I'm just going to drag it up right there. Then we of course want to delete our first one and drag the second one in place. Let's take a look. Nah, still is a little bit too short, so just drag it up even more. Right, so that looks really cool. So just mess around with the position keyframes to make sure the animation starts about right here and ends about right here. So I'm just going to do the same thing with the other one. Real quick. Alright, so if you play it back when you have finished the second one as well, it will look something like this. Perfect. So what we can do is just press U on both our keyframes to see all the keyframes that we have made. We can select the keyframes, press copy and just paste them like one or two more times in the timeline right here to loop it, and one more time towards the end. Just do the same thing with the other one. Let's take a look. What you can do as well is just offset one of these to begin a little bit early, and we have something that looks like this instead. Perfect, it's all up to you. Alright, so for the more like eye-catching thing that maybe you want to see is the like glowing fire effect. So the first thing I want to do is make a new layer by just click on this gray area right here. Just right click, new, make a new solid. Make sure the color is black. Put the mode on screen. And for this, we're going to use a free plugin called Saber. It's really easy to install and I use it all the time. Right, so I'm just going to search up Saber. Oops. Saber. Just drag it to our black solid. Sorry if you heard that. And down we get this like really intense glowing thing. Doesn't really matter because we're going to change the preset to... What did I use? Hot, I think. Yeah, hot. And we can change the glow color to the color we're using. Use the eyedropper tool. Let's see how it looks. This preset will take quite a bit to render out. Just let this bar right here get green and then you can play it. You can see it's really laggy right now. Alright, so it's time to make this look a little bit better. So let's zoom in a little bit. First off, you could use the move tool or V to drag it to one of the sides for now. And as you can see, we have those little points right here. I'm just going to drag them to like the end of the rectangle and do the same thing on top. Perfect. Just drag this layer below everything. And I only want the effect to be shown on this side because in the face cam we will have our face, etc. So grab our pen tool and make sure none of the layers are selected. So just make a shape kind of like so. Move up. And so it doesn't really have to be pretty or anything, but in this area the effect will be shown. So how do you do that? Grab this shape layer and put it above our black solid where the effect is on. Make sure you have the track matte mode selected. If you can't see it, just click toggle switches and modes. And we're going to make the black solid a track matte, an alpha matte to the shape layer 1. This alpha matte shape layer 1. And now the effect will be only shown in the shape. So let's select these two shapes. Control D to duplicate them and press R on both because we want to put it on the right side right now. Put the rotation value at 180 degrees and just select the black solid, and you might have to just move it to the other side. Just like so. Alright, so let's see how this looks. I'm just going to, it will take like 5 minutes or so depending on your computer to just let this render out, so I'll be back when that's done. Alright, so that looks really cool. If you think the glow part is like too fast, what you can do is go to distortion and then core distortion and put the wind speed to like I think 1 or 2 looks good. So I'm actually going to do that. Make sure you do that with both layers. Right, so I can see, as you can see, that's more like smooth and controlled. And let's see how it looks when we play through at the end right here. Oh, you can see that really like laggy jump. That will happen in our stream because this is going to be used as a loop. So now I'm just going to loop the effect. And the best way I found was just to animate the core size basically. So I'm just going to do that now. So put the core size at 0 seconds. First off, you need to make a keyframe by pressing the stopwatch. Put the core size to 0, move forward to about 0.5 seconds and put it back at a value you like. Press U on our layers, we can see the keyframes. Copy them, paste them to the other black solid. Right, so now we can to animate the queen back again so it will be as a loop. So make a keyframe for the core size again, move forward half a second, and put it at 0. Then put these two last keyframes at the end of the timeline. Just like so. Copy them and paste them to the second layer as well. So this is how we're going to loop the effect. And if you have a better way, please comment down below, because this is the only way I found. So let's see how it looks. Alright, so that is how it will look as looped, etc. So I think we're done with the animation part and it's time to export. The most important thing for a Facecam design is that it is transparent. So if we toggle the transparency mode, this little box right here, we can see that it's not transparent actually. So you can see we have these black solids and effects that it's causing these problems. So just click them, go to our effects controls, go to render settings, then composite settings, and put that to transparent, and do the same thing with the other one. So just render settings, composite settings, and transparent. Alright, so when we have made sure it's transparent, it's time to export, and then how to actually use it for your videos or your streams. So just go to File, Export, and we're going to add it to the render queue. Alright, so put the render settings could be at best settings, and the output module, click that. Put the format to QuickTime, and put the channels to RGB plus alpha. That is very important, because otherwise it won't be transparent when we export it. Right, so just click OK, and output to wherever you want it to be saved on your computer, and just click render. Alright, so now I'm going to show you how to use it for your streams. I'm using OBS for an example, but it will be quite similar in all other programs. So in the sources tab right here, just click the plus sign and select media source, create new. Let's find the file that we have exported, open it, and make sure it is selected as a loop. Make sure this box loop is selected. Okay, press OK, and there we have it. Looks really cool. So then you can of course just position it wherever you want, resize it, put your face cam over there in it of course, and all that. Alright, so thank you so much for watching this video, and as I said in the intro, if this video gets 800 likes, I will release the PSD of this, and the animation you will have to do for yourself. But yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure that you like this video, comment something nice or something that you want to see in the future, subscribe and turn on post notifications, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.